between 33rd and 31st Streets, 7th and 8th Avenues in Manhattan, Madison Square Garden. Marc-Andre Fleury, 8th year as the guy in the playoffs for the Penguins, 90th playoff start, 8 shutouts career, 2 in the last 4 days. Henrik Lundqvist, 8th year as the guy in the playoffs for the Rangers, 77th consecutive playoff start, career numbers, just like Fleury, 8 shutouts. Interesting, Captain Sidney Crosby scored his first goal in Game 3. He starts this game alongside Evgeny Malkin with a goal in this playoff series himself, and Chris Kunitz on the wing. The number one shutdown crew, Dan Girardi and Ryan McDonough for the Rangers. Derek Brassard, Matt Zuccarello, and Benoit Pouliot are up front. And Brooks Orpik is back in the lineup for Pittsburgh. Robert Bortuzzo sits. Daniel Carcillo and Chris Kreider in the lineup for the Rangers. JT Miller and Jesper Fast sit.
And Bortuzzo played really well, Doc, in this series with the injury to Brooks Orpik.
Nice to have that organizational depth if you're the Penguins and you plan on going for a long run.
Yeah, that trust factor.
Yep.
The first puck is Letang's, then Malkin's, then in. Girardi shoved off by Kunitz. Burrowing in Crosby. Girardi prevails. Zuccarello. Flopped high and back down. Stopped by Fleury and paddled on to Letang, who twirls. Dave Jackson, Dan O'Rourke, the referees for this game tonight as Malkin beats Crosby in speed. Dropped on the wing and away from Jokinen. Crosby checked his man. It's punched on back and settled down by Girardi. Derek Amell, Derek Nansen are the linesmen in the contest tonight. Kreider makes his first appearance, and the Rangers fans notice that. It is Stepan. Save Fleury, and the rebound jabbed wide. Kreider played it along, got it onto Nash, and around behind off of Stepan. Rising backhander by Nash, and he goes jamming away after the whistle, and a football pile-up in the goal crease.
Boy, it's nice to have some energy in the building, and if you're a Ranger fan, it's nice to see the energy from Chris Kreider. He got a nice ovation. Derek Stepan, Eddie talked about it, the Ranger center. Great drive, get it on goal. Rick Nash, get it out front. Eventually, Stepan gets separated from the puck. Nash gets the front, forcing Marc-Andre Fleury to another save, Eddie.
You want to score, you got to go to that area of the ice. Let's stop it right here. Here's an opportunity for Benoit Pouliot to go ahead and make contact with Chris Letang. This starts the forecheck, but watch what happens. This is a flyby. Chris Letang has that escapability. You got to make life difficult on a guy like Chris Letang and on a forecheck. The first forecheck of the game for the Penguins, Chris Kunitz finished his check below the goal line on Ryan McDonough, and then he finished a check on Matt Zuccarello. You want to play in the offensive zone? Sometimes you got to pick your spot on when to be physical to force possibly a turnover.
Richardson Gotch on the faceoff that is lobbed out by Bo Bennett, sent back on like Lee Stempniak. Moving in there along with Kevin Kline, it comes on around to Gotch. Gotch trying to turn away, gets away from Diaz. Bumped there though by Kline, and he prevails to hand on now to Marty St. Louis. Moving up with Richards and Carl Hagelin, but it's brushed aside. Gotch stood up effectively by Kline, and back deeper must go St. Louis.
Good pressure there from Bennett on the forecheck.
Eddie, what an underrated player he's become for the Penguins. He's going to be a really good one.
Oh, Brooks Orpik rams Richards, and there will be a discussion here.
Nowhere to go for Brad Richards here on this play. Brooks Orpik had a great gap, meaning not allowing time and space to make a play, and it was just a good hard hit by Brooks Orpik on Richards, and there you see the puck go into the Penguin bench.
Eddie, watch his face right into the turnbuckle there from Brooks Orpik. Hard physical play. Orpik's so comfortable playing on the left side, and he steps up when he has that gap you just alluded to.
Good thing there wasn't that turnbuckle there like it was in previous years. Now with the rounded boards there, great job by the National Hockey League to eliminate more danger areas on the ice. We've talked about there's no out of bounds in this game. Good physical play there from Brooks Orpik, and that's the way to get back into action. Well, that's a false faceoff. Clean win from Stepan, and
he's going to talk to Derek Amell. Joe Vitale said, I got to put my stick down first, don't I? 46 has to put a stick down first. There he does. And scrambles a draw.
Lob back on by Letang. After it, Gibbons. Jabbed on by Stahl. Followed up by Letang. Marches on and gets some help there, but it's kicked aside by Kreider. Right in front, had to be brushed away by Lundqvist. Taken on by Letang. Then Gibbons. Tied up, but he peels away. Got it on for a shot. Oh, and a scorching shot from Gibbons on the feed by Vitali. Back in deep, it's away from Adams. Punched along by Kreider and taken by Nash. Off of Kreider and grabbed further and dealt across by the defense of Paul Martin. Tipped on back to Stahl. And Stahl gives it on across. Teams from the neutralized area making player changes right now as this one is fired along and right back into Malkin, who steps in. Evgeny Malkin fed it on across to Crosby. The return off Malkin. He scores! A 360, and it is 1-0 in favor of the Penguins.
Well, the giveaway on the ice from Anton Stralman. He has the puck here. He tries to put this puck out into the neutral zone. It's stolen by the eventual goal scorer, Evgeny Malkin. I thought Crosby had a chance to shoot the puck there, but it finds its way to Malkin, and on a spin around on the backhand, beats Lundqvist.
Carcillo's got to come back a little better than that on Crosby, and then the spinning backhand by Malkin. That's just a catastrophe for the New York Rangers in terms of the start. They needed a better start than that. They had one thrust. They need to be better than that.
Crowd encouraging them before this faceoff. McDonough able to play it back out. Guided back to him again by Sutter, and so it must be taken back deeper and then handed on to McDonough by Brassard. Long toss by Stralman. Off of Zuccarello. Bounced on back. Penguins have done a good job of blocking pucks in the neutral zone here. A steal by Jokinen, fed back on for Sutter. Sutter rolled it back in and went to get his own pass. His line mates are now coming out. Sutter at the half board saw it flipped away. Given away, though, and it's right on goal on the toss by Bennett. And then battled for up the boards and worked on further by Sutter. Out there with James Neal and Bo Bennett right now. This one flung back ahead and chipped away by Sutter, regathered by Matt Niskanen.
That giveaway, Pierre, was by Pouliot right through the middle of the ice.
Agreed. If they don't start managing the puck, they're in big trouble on the blue team.
Got to keep the puck up the boards right now if you're the Rangers. Simplify the game. No passes through the middle of the ice.
Offside is called. 3:40 gone first period. 1-0 in favor of the Penguins. For extensive series coverage from the Stanley Cup playoffs, go to NHL.com from your computer or phone. Get video highlights and in-depth analysis of every game directly from the experts.
Give Dan Bylsma some credit here. He loads up with Crosby and Malkin to start the game. Their second shift. They come out on the ice without Girardi and McDonough on the ice. And the Penguins with a 1-0 lead. That was an extended shift as well for Stralman and Stahl. Penguins had a fresh line on the ice, but again, the turnover in the middle of the ice allowed that chance and the puck end up in the net.
Murray playing that one up into the mesh. Malkin his second from Crosby, the lone assist at 2:31. They each got scoring points on the lone goal.
You could see Crosby's game start to turn in game two. He had six shots on goal, played over 20 minutes. In game number three, he had one shot on goal and one goal in a little over 16 minutes. And they were able to manage his minutes in that game just because they were so solid defensively. But again, I think you could start to see Crosby really start to elevate in game number two of this series.
Malkin's second goal of the series, his fifth goal overall, as Paul Martin weaves his way along and hands it on to Malkin. But it is McDonough. McDonough stolen away by Malkin, fed just away from Crosby. Letang, side of the net, tried to shot past Crosby, and that one ricocheted off him, but he goes right back after it. Crosby able to fire it back. Letang there, spun it across. Martin with a shot, and it's sealed up by Lundqvist. Captain Morgan, white rum takes you inside the glass. Here's Pierre.
New York Rangers need to wake up and wake up, but soon, because, Doc, if they don't, they're in big trouble. You cannot turn the puck over against a quality team like the Pittsburgh Penguins. Dan Girardi with a flip out, Anton Stralman turnover. That eventually leads to the goal by Malkin, and they continually turn the puck over, and I love what Eddie Olchuk just said. You got a New York Rangers sweater on right now, not through the middle. Up the boards and get your confidence, chip it deep, start the cycle. Things through the middle are getting devoured by the Penguins.
Turnovers 3-0 Rangers. Along with this one now is Gibbons. Wraparound is cut off by Lundqvist, who is busy.
Well, Brian Gibbons found himself with a little advantage on Mark Stahl off that faceoff, and he came wrapping the puck around to the left of Henrik Lundqvist. There's Gibbons. He beats Stahl, and now he's got a step. Nice little play there from Vitali to allow Gibbons that open ice in behind the net, and Lundqvist has to make a stop.
Eddie, the Rangers wanted Dan Carcillo in the lineup to provide energy. He's been beaten down the ice once by Crosby, and right there he got beat by Gibbons off the faceoff. He's got to be harder on people.
Boyle hands it on to him. Carcillo rolled it on through, and Brooks Orpik chased that one down. Played back along now, and ahead by Scuderi, carried out by Craig Adams.
Good hit by Boyle behind the play there, Doc and Rob Scuderi.
Hooked on around now for Strawman. Boomed into there by Adams. Battled for by Carcillo, and knifed right away from him. He comes back again, and this time it is kicked loose from him, and then played right back through him onto the point now for Orpik, and his shot got the glass. There was talk of taking the crowd out of it earlier in the pregame. The first goal has done some of that. These people are pretty resilient. And they challenge their team, but also encourage them after that 1-0 goal that still stands. Thrown on across now for Diaz, and a pad block was made there by Fleury. Mata tries to play. Curled away from him. Duels with Zuccarello, protects it, feathered it through. James Neal had it knifed away. Walked on, and a pass is cut by Sutter, and he can start to work on Rafael Diaz. Played it on through the Swiss-born defenseman. Punched right back again by Fleury, very close to the pie slice, and a minor. Played back across for the carry back on now by Klein. Protected, gave it on across for Haglund, and a hurried shot. Ricocheted and popped on back for Penguin control. My goodness, pretty impressive that time.
Good rush there from Klein, jumping into the play that made the whole play.
Cut back by Malkin, handled by Letang, and turning stick of Crosby, and back in. Wide of the cage, and the bouncer over near Girardi. Rocks into and cancels with Kunitz to the back for Martin, and that one deflected up into the mesh. Evgeny Malkin with a smile, his team with a lead. Midway, first period in New York.
Through the neutral zone against the Penguins, you're going to get some opportunities. Two Penguin forwards caught. Here comes Kevin Klein, a 4-on-3 situation. Move the puck, continue on, and just a missed opportunity there. But the right idea there by Klein to jump into play, recognizing they had two Penguin forwards caught in behind the play. Those plays are there for the Rangers. Got to execute when they do come front and center.
Goal for the stop by Fleury. I think that was a stretch pass that didn't pan out or just get rid of it. Tipped along by Kunitz, and it dropped on back to center.
Looking for maybe possibly just a little chip and chase there, Doc, but certainly trying to stretch out the defense of the Penguins from that area of the ice.
Martin and Letang, Malkin, Crosby, and Kunitz. That's a lot of talent. Kunitz pivoting with this one. Shoves it across, but into the path of Kreider. Gave it right back, though. And Kunitz, a backhander that had to be shrugged down by McDonough. Kunitz tangles there. Kreider twisted it to Kunitz, to across to Malkin. And Malkin pivots with this one. Rifled it on back for Letang. Drove one off of Malkin. Stick wide. Rebound is tucked around in front. All Penguins right now.
Chris Kreider's having a tough time handling the puck. That would be explainable because of the hand surgery that he's coming back from. He's really having timing issues with the puck.
Since March 21st, he has been gone. Stempniak, crossover, no! Save me! Rebound! The late penalty call coming up here against the Rangers. Settled down by Scuderi, and a shot was knifed loose in front. The Rangers touch, and a power play coming up for the Penguins.
Lee Stempniak came over from the Calgary Flames at the trade deadline of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Skilled player out of Dartmouth College on Ryan McDonough. Ryan McDonough has not looked right this entire series. I have to believe that he's injured. And Henrik Lundqvist comes up with a large save. And eventually Carl Hagelin reaches in with a stick right there on the left hand of Stempniak, and he gets a hooking penalty. Eddie, I'm a huge Ryan McDonough fan. I admire the courage he's showing right now, but he is not the same player.
It seems like he's fighting it for sure. But somehow you just got to gut it out and chip away. Oh, not very often you ever see him get beaten like that, especially to the inside.
Miller Lite presents this power play. It is so often by this time of year, and this is only round two of four. Teams are not in the business of journalism, but you sense, as Pierre's just said, that there's something that has been harming McDonough and others on both teams as this is sent all the way back down. Long toss by Fleury, brought ahead now by Niskanen, and yanked back in. Stall to play it there. Run off by Neal. Bounced off of it, gave it away to Niskanen. Onto the back now for Paul Martin. Then along to Niskanen again. Niskanen settled it down to Jokinen. Gave it on over to Martin. Back to Niskanen. Over to Jokinen. Dealt back in deep for Neal. Neal's pass was chipped, but over to the glove of Jokinen. Stashed it back to Neal. Looks to the front. Gives back to Jokinen again. Rifled it over. Martin holds there. To the back to Niskanen. Drove one side of the net, and it was blocked wide, and then can be played on by Jokinen. Feathered on through. Niskanen there. And a shot is slowed down. Started out by Dominic Moore, and he rolls a bouncer in on Fleury, and he jabbed it away from the onrushing San Luis. No shots on this power play yet.
No, the Penguins had the puck for the majority of that power play in the zone, but Rangers did a good job of keeping them to the outside for the most part.
Through the legs pass by Crosby is flagged and carried out by Nash. Sized up by Martin, and it's flung wide off the glass. 25 left on the power play. Crosby hoisted one ahead that is leapingly grabbed by McDonough and shuttled off to Stepan.
What an athletic play. If he doesn't make that play, Quinnitz is in all alone.
Big rebound left there, but it can be collared by Letang and sent ahead, but off the stick of Bo Bennett. Kevin Klein turns with that one, run off by Bennett. Puck still up for grabs. Rocking in was Boyle. It's cleared, but right under the stick of Malkin, who holds. Malkin dropped one side of the net, trying to march through was Bennett, taken along by Malkin again, and he's got it. Evgeny Malkin laid it to the back now. Scuderi fires, and that one wide. Rebound! Oh, and it wouldn't go for Bennett! My goodness! Around behind Bennett again. Bennett able to turn to the outside, dropped it back onto Crosby. Bent one in front that's blocked away by Lundqvist and steered back up ice. Zuccarello carries it on and flies it to the corner. Stepping in is Carl Hagelin. Ducked out of the way and then was bumped into there by Letang. Slow to get up, but he has gotten up. As you watch play evolve for Penguin control, banked on by Stempniak, squibbed out to center, plowed into with Strawman. All of this on a delayed offside.
Got a heck of a battle right in front of Pierre with Danny Malkin and Brian Boyle right in front of the inside the glass position.
A safety play by Lundqvist. It is 1-0 in favor of Pittsburgh midway first. Edward Jones FaceTime Pierre is with Rangers head coach Alain Vigneault.
Coach, obviously you'd like a better start. How come so many turnovers?
It's a good question, and you can't do that against such a strong team. I mean, puck management is a key, especially through that neutral zone. Most of their chances have come off our mistakes.
You're not too worried about matchups right now, obviously, trying to get some offense. How much of a lift will Kreider give your team?
Well, he's a big part of our team, and he brings us a lot of speed, and he brings us physicality up front. Hopefully he can keep it going.
Thanks a lot, Alain.
Thanks, Pierre.
Turnovers in the game. 8 by the Rangers, 2 by the Penguins. Off this tie-up, it is tangled up in skates and fished free all the way to the back to Martin. Martin banged it back in again, and around it careened over near Gotch. Played on further for a feed, and a quick shot by Gibbons had to be blocked down in front by McDonough. Lobbed along now by Pouliot. Working back in is Brassard. Checked by Gotch. Pouliot came by, and squibbed loose and can be taken to the outside and led on to the back. McDonough there, and Marc-Andre Fleury is not back to his feet. His goal stick is behind the net, and he'll have time to get it now.
A little bit of bumping going on there with Lee Stempniak, his teammate, the side of the net.
Zuccarello threw it in, carried off by Martin. It's handed on to Letang and banked on around for Kunitz. Tried to shuffle it through, no luck there. Kunitz working further, jammed it onto Malkin, and he floated it ahead for Crosby. Knifed away by the reach of Rick Nash. Martin connects with Crosby, then on to Malkin. Malkin able to work his way by, but the puck poked away and a good reach there by Strawman. And then off the boards, played back out again by Stepan. Held by Kunitz, flopped across past Crosby, sent back out by Strawman, and regathered by Orpin. Crosby through the legs and back on now for Kunitz to play back in. 71 looks very impressive. I know he scored a goal, but just off the score sheet, the chances he generates and some of the moves he's made are reminiscent of times past.
Less restriction for Malkin when he's playing the wing position, not compared to playing the center ice position. Talk about a real good save. Watch this save here by Henrik Lundqvist off of Bo Bennett. Shot by Scuderi, missed the net, comes back out. And a tremendous save there. And talked about Stempniak and Marc-Andre Fleury coming together. It's because Derek Brassard hit Stempniak into the goaltender. As you mentioned, Doc, his stick in behind the net. One thing that the Rangers have done, and they haven't had a lot of territorial play, they have gotten to the front of the net here tonight when they've been in the offensive zone.
Conversation between Dan O'Rourke, the referee, and Alain Vigneault with Ulf Samuelsson. Arms folded nearby, too.
He had a few of those collisions back in the day.
Generated some. Quickly off it comes to Neal, who got the glass with the shot just thrown missed. On by Niskanen.
That's his area, too. He loves shooting from there. He plays with Malkin. Malkin usually wins the faceoff right there.
Carl Hagelin ahead. St. Louis lost. Away from Sutter, regathered by Diaz. Incline the defense. Against Jokinen and Neal and Sutter, who intercepted there. Diaz nudged it on. Boyle played it in. Mata, and then ahead by Jokinen. Settled down by Neal, and right in stride comes Sutter. Up the wing, shot one, pad stop, and a big rebound all the way to center from Lundqvist. Canceling out Scuderi as well as Dominic Moore. So now Scuderi with 7 minutes to go, first period. The shots are 6-3 in favor of the Penguins. Giveaway came there from Gibbons, marching back in now as Carcillo, and a save is made by Fleury. Played off by Gibbons, taken and sent along by Craig Adams. Brushed away from Vitali, lobbed back in again by Dominic Moore. Orpik jostled off there. Pouliot knocked into him. Meanwhile, it's played along by Scuderi, and Pouliot able to knock it away. Tried to center. Scuderi flagged that. Given quickly across by Vitali. Orpik there, booted into by Zuccarello, and it's played back behind, and the Rangers are following through in their chance. This unit is acting like it's very healthy, Pierre. On comes Kreider, shooting one, and that kicked aside by Orpik. Kreider again, crowd into this. Nash fed it, side of the net, and blocked there from Scuderi. To the back again, Strawman a shot, and that one blocked in front by Stempniak. Can't get by with it. Punched along by Kreider. Around behind for Nash. Able to avoid Orpik and got it back to Strawman, and a shot, and that one screamed off somebody wide. Can be kept alive by McDonough. Played back on to Brassard. McDonough hands it on across. Strawman with the shot, and that blocked away by Orpik. Twisted along behind by Kreider, right back out in front, protected and snuffed by Brassard, off of Scuderi, who brushes it back on. Strawman keeps the pressure on. And then a pass is tipped back down by Adams, and it will go all the way back for Ranger retrieval. The fans like the attack they've seen. Many of them are standing. Hoisted along by St. Louis and walked back in by Richards. Once the backhand sent it on net, and it's collared there and then frozen by Fleury. .507 to go. Ranger attack has been shut down for now. Some snarl. Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico.
Welcome back to New York, where the Rangers are trailing 1-0. Puck on goal, Marc-Andre Fleury freezing. There's one little whack for Mark Stahl. Nothing wrong there. Stick comes in to Evgeny Malkin's face. I think that's where the slashing penalty will be called. But the Rangers were confused. They weren't sure if it's the first time he whacked away at Fleury or the high stick on Evgeny Malkin.
Now the first one clearly looked like he went for the glove and Fleury moved it and ended up hitting the net. I think that's exactly where the call was made. And everybody coming together, a couple of good pops on either side in that big fray.
Our play is sponsored by Husk Barnard.
Eddie, I got to tell you, Doc made a point about Evgeny Malkin. He's jumping right now. Crosby, Letang, and Malkin are really jumping. You could just see it. They're so much better than earlier in the playoffs.
They're there together right now. Backhander in front, jammed free by McDonough and cleared back down.
McDonough did a good job there of staying loose, not getting tied up and able to get to that puck. Again, I go back to the Malkin factor on the wing position. A lot less responsibility as a winger at this level than playing a center ice position, especially when it comes to the defensive side.
Cleared again by the Rangers. Penguins were shotless on their first power play. This is the second one. They have not had a shot on goal in a while here. A while being defined as probably 5 minutes or so. Carried back ahead now by Crosby. Dealt back for Malkin. Malkin, a shot. He tried the long side. Did not miss by much, but it careens back down. 45 gone on the penalty kill of the Rangers. Some good, heady, hard work done there by Dominic Moore. How many times and how many towns have we said that about Dominic Moore? He comes to the bench now. Right back ahead comes Malkin. Malkin delays and looks over the traffic. Little head direction there toward Martin as it's sent across. Trying to jam one along with Letang, and it's taken back by Stepan. Moving back on, a couple of Penguins watching him. He goes to the Crosby side. Stepan met there, and he fired one wide. Tangles up with Paul Martin now. No shots for the Penguins on this power play yet. Jokinen slowed this one down and wheeled it on back for Martin. Half a minute to go. Letang steps ahead, plays it on now for Jokinen, and that one cleared away. Niskanen can handle in the last 20. Glides ahead, does Niskanen, got it on for Jokinen. Jokinen guided it around behind, and it came back over for Haglund. Menaced enough by Neal that it came free, popped near McDonough, and McDonough shakes it back along, and Neal got it there. James Neal settling things down. Neal just holding. Penalty time is up now to stall. Fed back for a centering pass, and Jokinen could not control. And then a drive by Niskanen flapped off the glass. Haglund skied one along that bounces over near Boyle and Sutter. Can be played back on now to Bennett. Here's Bennett's shot, and it ricocheted off McDonough and went wide. Carried back up by the Rangers and advanced on for a fling by Brassard that went wide. Reversed back up the boards on the backhand of Scuderi. Battled for by Diaz. Pumped along for Pouliot. Checked off by Stempniak. Then played by Brassard again. Rattled around near Zuccarello. Run into by Orpik. Puck flexed ahead. But right to Zuccarello. Gave it up to Orpik, who tried to sky one ahead and got it off the short glass to center. Rushed right back on and left behind and then taken on by Stempniak. Rifled it across to Bennett to dodge, and the shot was blocked down by the defense. Played back up to Brassard, 2:10 to go, and back and forth they go, probing for a goal here.
Good block there from Klein.
Niskanen takes this one. And gently sent it back in where Girardi was able to backhand it along into some traffic, but Stahl able to get it as far as center. Mata hands it across to Adams, and then on the turning stick of Niskanen. Flies it right back in again, and Vitali for that one, but offside is called. It all gets settled on Championship Sunday. 20 Premier League teams will meet one last time to determine their fate. Championship Sunday coverage begins Sunday morning at 10 Eastern on NBCSN. Simulcast in Espanol on Telemundo and Mundos. Neutralized faceoff on this. 1:44 to go, first period. The shots about 8 minutes ago were 6-3, Pittsburgh. Now it is 6-5. Another shotless power play for the Penguins, and this is protected by Paul Martin and whacked along by Kunitz, who was walled there by Girardi and then retaliates with a two-hander on him, and that'll be a penalty against Pittsburgh. The Rangers operate on the delayed call, twisted across now to San Luis in the last minute, 20 of the period.
Not a good penalty from Chris Kunitz at all. Took exception to the hit, swung his stick carelessly. Right call made.
Totally agree.
San Luis had it knocked away by Letang, and the call will be made.
Hey, the hit happened right in front of me, and it was a rough ride. It's not an easy ride to take from Danny Girardi. And I think what bothered Kunitz more than anything else, you watch the hit, his face goes right into the top of the boards. And that's what he didn't like very much, and then he just whacks away with one hand. That's a little sales job by Girardi, by the way, but nonetheless, that was an undisciplined penalty by Chris Kunitz.
And Chris Kunitz did a little selling job earlier in the series when Derek Dorsett hit him from behind and eventually led to cushion goal for the Penguins earlier in the series. I think what made that hit so dangerous was that the collision there with St. Louis as well when Girardi was stepping up on Kunitz.
I'm not saying there's hockey karma, are you?
It is Sutter marching ahead and firing one that is chested down and then covered by Lundqvist. Talking earlier today to Dan Bylsma, the coach of the Penguins, about the penalty kill and how splendid it's been, not only against the Rangers but others, and in particular, Brandon Sutter. And he said when he was in Carolina, he was more of a fill the lane and block the shot guy. And here it is more angling, directing pucks to the corner. Similar to what he as a player experienced in Anaheim when there was a coaching change and he went from being a lane shot blocker to an angler because of the new coach there, Mike Babcock.
Well, there's medical trainer Doc Jim Ramsey out there attending to Henrik Lundqvist. He got a high, hard one here from Brandon Sutter outside the blue line there and just catching him right under the mask. And took him a second to kind of get his wits about him and get back to his feet and be okay.
Outside of being pulled in game six against Philadelphia for the third period, he's played every single second of the New York Rangers postseason.
Going back about 7 years with all the starts. It is Zuccarello. This one popped down, everyone looking for it, and it is cleared back down.
Those are kind of battles that the Rangers have to win. Outnumbering the Penguins, they had everything going there, and somehow Scuderi finds it and airmails it all the way down.
Good rush by McDonough, slung it on across Brassard. Backhanded one that's off Fleury, and he's able to hang on.
I think Ryan McDonough's legs are fine, Eddie and Doc. I'm not sure his upper body's fine, and that's why we're not seeing him launch the puck. It's a nice piece of distribution right there. And launched on goal by Derek Brassard on the back and then a little whack away at the free hand of Fleury. But I just think there's something clearly wrong with his upper body. He's not nearly as strong in one-on-one situations as we're used to seeing.
Off this tie-up with Stepan, it's slugged on by Gotch and cleared back down by Paul Martin. For the last five, there will be 51 seconds of carryover time into the second period. And the horn beats the intended blast of the Avs. Coming up on the Lexus Intermission Report, Rangers plagued by turnovers, Canadiens-Bruins Game 4 preview. Malkin and Crosby started the game on the same line, finished the first period on the same line, and figured in the only goal. Malkin got it, Crosby the primary and only assist, 1-0 Penguins. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by Lexus and their pursuit of perfection. By Carfax, find the right car with the right history. Shop now at Carfax.com. And by Miller Lite, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time. Back here at Madison Square Garden on the fifth floor, they have penalty boxes here. There's only one occupant. That's the guy, a slashing minor. And a power play that has 52 seconds to go on a fresh sheet of garden ice for the New York Rangers. Off the short glass to Diaz. Has Girardi to work a point on this power play. Gives back to Diaz again. Diaz floated it past Paul Martin. Around it comes for Scuderi. Rattled it along off of Nash. Closed off there, and the Penguins are able to clear. The hit was applied by Adams.
Great help there from Rob Scuderi after Adams was along the boards. Support, won the foot race. Easy clear.
20 to go on the power play. Rangers empty in their last 34. And a shot by Kreider is patted right back out again by Fleury. Now Nash. Grips and shot one, and that one ricocheted off Fleury. To the back it comes for Girardi to Nash again. Crosses, tried to poke one through, but it was deflected by Gibbons. Pumped around behind for Kreider, twisted to the front, off Stepan, and then thrown all the way for right out of the box, Kunitz. And handed on now to Gibbons. Kunitz nearby. Gibbons grip. Sent one just wide of the top right. Touched across by Letang. Rescued by Mata. And blasted back off the waffle board and the stick of Lundqvist. 1:15 gone. Second period. Full strength action. Malkin able to kick that one along. And it's feathered right back to Zuccarello, who hoisted it on back to center. Malkin moves ahead, has Crosby breaking. In the way, Pouliot re-grabs and starts back the other way for the Rangers. They're down in the series by one. They're down in this game by one. Pouliot a shot, and that eaten up by Fleury. And a little extra right at the side of the net.
And go back to that play one-on-one in the first period with Lee Stempniak and Ryan McDonough. I want everybody to watch the feet here of Ryan McDonough. Lee Stempniak's watching his feet. As soon as McDonough starts crossing over to the outside, Stempniak knows that he cannot cross back and come back and be able to deny that opportunity. Great play there from Stempniak.
And Eddie, let's look at the body of work of why potentially Ryan McDonough's not playing very well. There's Alex Burrows in the regular season. Left shoulder, clearly a problem, and Jim Ramsey addresses it. First round, Zach Rinaldo and he run into one another. You can see he's flinching, and the left arm and the left shoulder do not look good. A big reason why I don't think McDonough's playing very well. I don't think he's 100% or anywhere close to it.
Here, this may not be new because you did talk with Alain Vigneault, but do you think that what he told you is the same thing he told his team in the intermission?
Absolutely. And Jeremy, Mike, Liam were talking about a puck management so important. We showed a bunch of video about it early on. They have to manage the puck better. They have to get pucks in deep, and they have to start getting pucks on goal with traffic going to the net. It's too easy for Fleury right now.
They had the one shift there in the first period with the Brassard, Zuccarello, Pouliot line. But other than that, been a lot of one and done. Not a lot of sustained pressure and pushback by the Rangers in the offensive zone. In order to do that, you need support. You need strength in numbers. You've got to be able to win some foot races. You got to win some physical battles as well.
Yanked along now to James Neal. Marc-Andre Fleury has stopped the last 66 in a row. A steal there, and Strawman swung it across, and they got over-anxious, and so offside. Call Star NHL to download NHL Game Center and get a free premium upgrade only on Verizon. Enjoy exclusives like free live NBC national games. Never be without hockey.
You know, Eddie and Doc, one of the guys that's really done a good job with this Penguins team in terms of penalty kill, Tony Granato. He's on the bench tonight. He and Jacques Martin usually flip-flop. Tonight, Granato's down on the bench, but I think Tony's done a fantastic job with this penalty killing group all season long.
Part of the first family of hockey in the United States. Tony Granato, Downers Grove, Illinois native. Of course, his sister Cammy, celebrated American woman hockey player.
Hockey Hall of Famer.
Bouncer is sent aside by Fleury, overskated there, and it is played along. It was Carcillo who overskated the play. This one has popped on now for Dominic Moore to settle down, posted right back out as far as center by Scuderi, carried on by Stempniak, but then lost to Carcillo and brushed on by Stempniak onside. Held there by Bennett, the shot ricocheted off of Lundqvist, kicked on back to Letang, given across now to Scuderi, played into a vacant corner, occupied now by Gotch. Gotch fed one, Stempniak a shot, and that blocked away, and can be started back out by the Rangers on the attack. 3 minutes into the second period. Carcillo sent it to the corner and moves in on Letang. Letang fired it around, but ricocheted back for Carcillo to play. Up the boards, chipped on out to center, and it is gathered in by Girardi. Fed right back ahead, up the wing, Boyle fires! Oh, getting a piece of that hard, heavy shot was Fleury.
Got some tired defensemen on the ice right now for the Penguins.
Backhander is cut in front, and Letang can steer it on. The period of the long change, of course. Gibbons rustled off, but recovers and steps back in, but that play is offside. Captain Morgan White-Rum takes you inside the glass with Pierre.
The Rangers are really hoping that Chris Kreider can make a difference for them in this game number four. So his speed with Derek Stepan, that's something they're looking for, going hard to the net. They don't want to see that. Turnovers in the middle of the ice. They don't want to see this. Blowing a tire early on, timing is clearly an issue. But they need the size, they need the speed, and they need the shooting of Chris Kreider to make a difference here in game four.
This one is plopped back down. No icing on this play as Ole Mata is back for that. 19 years of age. Banged one on, but it went through Gibbons. Corralled by Girardi, and Girardi can swing it back. And on the bounce, right near Mata. Played along by Stepan. Hacked it on now for Kreider. Right around in front. He wiped out put it away by Mata. And back comes Crosby. Help came from Malkin to give it back onto Crosby. Fiddles to the outside. Malkin took it there. Ran into some traffic. And then Malkin to the outside. Chopping again. It came on back to center. A little ragged there. Looked like Malkin might be able to make something of it. Fired off the boards. Right out in front. Oh, and Lundqvist for the charging move there. What a wonderful play on Jokinen by the Ranger goaltender. Back the other way with this now. Pouliot gave it on to Stepan. Could not work by. Martin sends it on. It's fire wagon. Crazy stuff here as Martin is able to bring it right back along. Martin, nice move. Popped one off of Diaz to the glass. Went after it again, but Diaz prevailed on this one. Diaz menaced back off by the checking of James Neal, but then it's handed on to Strawman, and he has a little more room. Strawman able to shake to center, tries to step by. Brassard helped him to play it along. Letang muscled it on to Sutter, and it's as far as center. Nearly 5 minutes played, second period, game four. 1-0 on the very early goal by Evgeny Malkin. Pouliot popped one along, and it glanced over near Martin, is whacked at to the corner, and Martin played it on further. James Neal there, tumbling down to the ice with Sutter, floated back past Martin. Zuccarello rocked there by Letang. Centering pass was blocked aside. Beg your pardon, that was Brassard, who was hit by Letang. And this one skipped just away from Neal, retrieved by McDonough. Change in lines for the Penguins. Change executed by the Rangers. Motoring right in, and he's on the score!
Well, here's the eventual goal score. But watch this area of the ice for Carl Hagelin. Matt Niskanen gets out. He thinks the pass is going to go there, and all of a sudden, Hagelin just goes right between Skinnerian and Niskanen, goes top shelf on Fleury.
What a nice pass by Ryan McDonough, and then the breathtaking speed of Carl Hagelin. He just blows right through the Pittsburgh Penguin defense, and all it took was that little bad body position for Matty Niskanen to create that chance. Now we have a building that's alive.
145 and a half minutes of shutout hockey woven by Marc-Andre Fleury. This one is sent along and a backhand, and then Vitali to the front. Niskanen fires one off the boards, off Lundqvist, popped up in the air, trying to knock it loose, and getting a backhander wide was Vitali. Wow. Good pressure by the Penguins here as it's angled on as far as center. Niskanen flopped it back on again. Adams dueling there, wiped out with Diaz. Close quarters off of Adams, rescued by Vitali. McDonough, the lone assist on Hagelin's goal. So we are knotted up as Kunitz got it to Crosby, and a shot is blocked away to the corner by Kevin Klein. Hagelin gave it up to Malkin. Malkin got it to the back. Letang drilled one, touched by Crosby, and sent wide by Malkin. Jabbed on the backhand to center, retrieved by Martin, fed through now to Crosby. Crosby drifting with it, has Malkin nearby. Hands it to him, then back to Martin. Martin faked the drive and now slides it across to Letang. Drive by Kunitz, and that deflected to the glass, settled down by Malkin, played it front, and hanging on is Lundqvist. The guy out of the University of Michigan has tied this game midway in the second, 1-1.
Welcome back to the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Geico. Go back to the goal. Here's Matt Niskanen. He thinks that Carl Hagelin's going to make the pass here, but he doesn't. He decides to shoot the gap. Watch what happens. Watch Niskanen leave because he thinks the pass is going there, and that opens up the scene for Hagelin to go top shelf on Marc-Andre Fleury.
Little adjustment the Penguins made after their game one overtime loss. After every TV timeout, Malkin, Crosby, and Kunitz on the ice. Doesn't matter whether they're at home or on the road. Danny Bilesman wants to ride his thoroughbreds as hard as he can.
Ryder, but Crosby in front. Oh, and Malkin's shot was blocked by Lundqvist.
What a pass by Crosby, and an even better stop from Lundqvist.
That's why you play the thoroughbreds.
Nash to the front. Oh, and it was directed off the pad of Fleury. Nash drags this one around, gets it around to the outside, wheels, and shoots. Blocked down in front. Paul Martin tied up his man, Kreider. Comes to the bench now slowly. Meanwhile, back on the attack, the Penguins and Kunitz got it on across. Hurried shot by Malkin. and that one screamed off and went out of play. Oh, man.
What a couple of great chances at either end. What a pass from Sidney Crosby to Evgeny Malkin. Pressure forecheck. Girardi's got it. Turnover. Quick pass. Great save there from Henrik Lundqvist. And then back the other end.
Anything you can do, they can do better, Eddie. Nice job. Kreider keeps it alive. Then you're going to see off the knee of Kreider and a little battle, and Sidney Crosby's there to clean it up, and Kreider goes limping to the bench.
That was a terrific stop by Fleury. That one went off the redirection. Doc mentioned went off the stick of Paul Martin. Had to make a left pad save there as he was moving back to his right.
Doc played that one back in off of Bennett. And now Stahl. Will it be icing? No, they say. Waving it off. It comes near Fleury. Along as Mata. Poked it on now to Stempniak. He delayed and then got into trouble with the checking of Dominic Moore. Rattled it on around and stepping to this is Stahl. Stahl pushed it around behind. Moore got it there. Has Carcillo nearby. Shoved off by Mata. Moore pulls off the boards, got it on back to Strawman, pumped it around for Moore, upended there, tripped over the stick that was loose from Mata, and it is fired on for the carry back out by Bennett. Side by side with Stempniak, drifts off now, Bennett challenged there by Stahl and rubbed out. Stempniak took care of Strawman, it's pitched on now for Carcillo, trying to play out, has to double back now, and is able to hand it behind. Some pretty effective forechecking done there by Sutter for the moment, but now right back they bring it. Rolled in by Pouliot, gotten by Letang, fed it back across to Neal, back up come the Penguins, right on the stick of Sutter, rolled it, took his own pass, backhanded one in front, the shutdown. Rebound, jab four there by Jokinen, back up the boards to Martin. Martin carried off, but it's taken and thrown back along again by Sutter. Off of Martin, trying to work, but it's carried back up ice now by Pouliot. Harassed by Martin, but he prevailed to backhand it in, and it is Fleury. Turning it along to Letang, right up the boards to Jokinen, and they march back out again. It's Paul Martin ahead with it now. Martin able to gain the zone, looked a little crazy there, didn't it? And then Jokinen, a shot that is sealed up by Lundqvist. Like it might have been offside.
Very close, Doc, yeah. I agree with you. It looked like it was very close to being offside. James Neal in a step early, maybe in front of Paul Martin, right in that area there. Can't tell from that look, but what an opportunity, though. Neal holds, 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 gets the puck to the front of the net. And the opportunity and a good stop.
If we could see that one.
Yeah, it looks like the leg is up there. Yeah, I think it was offside because it looked like Neal's left skate was up before the puck got in over the blue line.
Punch back along by Scuderi. Malkin with four of the eight Penguins' chances, and another one comes wheeling in off of Gibbons. Had to be blocked by Lundqvist.
Nice redirect there from Craig Adams.
Brought ahead by Hagelin and played back in, hoping for San Luis. Reaching it there is Malkin, or rather, Mata, and then around to the outside. It's punched behind now for San Luis again, trying to dance free. Angles it on back. Strawman had to settle it down and lost the center, and then flopped it back in, delayed offside as White. Richards to the bench. 10:05 to go. Second period of play, game tied. Lundqvist stopped that and paddled it on to Strawman, nudged on further for Stepan, and he marches on. It's Stepan feeding one across and diving to the ice, trying to make the play. Was Kreider, and so back on Malkin, hands on to Crosby, picks up Martin, it's on to Malkin, Malkin fed across to Crosby, it's directed over, and Letang is there. Letang nicely stepping by, it's punched aside, and an offhand 3-on-1. Stepan gives up the wing, Nash is in, and the shot goes wide, and the net is dislodged. 9:34 to go, second period of play, game tied. Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre is with Penguins head coach Dan Bylsma.
You happy with this wide open approach?
No, we don't like it one bit. They've made some long plays here throughout the whole game here. And that last one, in the goal they scored, we got caught on a long play. They made one to speed from behind, and Hagelin went right through.
Is it clear to say or fair to say that you're using Crosby, Kunitz, and Malkin after every TV timeout?
Well, you want to get those guys on the ice as much as possible. And we have used them and tried to push forward anytime in the offensive zone as well.
Thanks a lot, Dan.
And Dan Bylsma right now down Chris Letang, who went into the locker room, looked like with a skate issue, and as well, we have not seen Brooks Orpik at all.
It is a skate issue, Eddie, and he will be back sooner rather than later.
And we have not seen Brooks Orpik in this period. So the Penguins right now with only five defensemen. Now only four because of the issue with Chris Letang.
Had a skate issue in practice this morning as well, so maybe something that's chronic. But at any rate, this is Mata waiting behind. Out in front is Nash with Brassard and Pouliot. Crosby across, and it's directed out of play into the coach, Alain Vigneault, by McDonough.
Right before that TV timeout, what an opportunity for the Rangers. A three-on-one situation. Watch this puck when it comes off the stick of Rick Nash. It just flutters. Missed opportunity, but you saw right before he shot the puck went up off the ice. It wasn't flat, and that's why it came off the stick with hardly any steam on it. And when you're really struggling to score goals, those type of things happen. And in that situation there, if you're a goal scorer like Rick Nash, you get to that spot, you're just putting your head down and you're firing it as hard as you can. You're not taking a wrist shot. You're going to take a heavy slapper and just try to put it right through the goaltender.
A league-leading 42 shots on goal for Rick Nash. Still looking for goal number one. Stempniak pivoting with it now. Trying to shake free, and he does. Stempniak tried to backhand one in front, and it ricocheted stiffly off Klein, who alertly played it along. Then Gotch around behind. Trying to pull free is Bennett. Gets it on back now for Scuderi. Wristed one off the boards that had to be blocked by the nub of the stick at the end there of Lundqvist. Meanwhile, the battle continues in the corner and eventually sped back out now for Zuccarello, who shook it back in. Zuccarello got there first along with Martin, and then Scuderi turned dangerously toward the front of the net. It is lifted back along for the carry back up by Bennett. Filtered it through off the stick of Zuccarello and swept back in by Goff.
Well, the Rangers, you know exactly what's going on with the defense of the Pittsburgh Penguins right now with no Letang and no Orpik, so you want to force the Penguin defenseman to really defend down here, get on the body, play below the goal line, make life really tough on those four defensemen.
And if you're Pittsburgh, you want to do just the opposite, get it down to the Rangers zone and grind on them so your defense can get a rest. And there's one they're trying to accomplish there, but they iced it.
As Formula One's elite descend on Europe, Team Mercedes continues to dominate. Will Sebastian Vettel rebound in a land known for rampaging bulls? Formula One Pirelli's Spanish Grand Prix, live Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. on NBCSN. That was quite a take. All of a sudden, your head jerked around. What was wrong with that? Well, the skate seems to be repaired, and of course, it will take some time. Or Letang. So it is tucked right back across. Jab back along off of Neal. Can be played further and blasted back in by Girardi, who is jostled by Jokinen.
Letang walked through the crowd there, Doc, in behind the Penguin player bench and is now available for action for Dan Bowser.
This is Niskanen, and I appreciate your clarifying that, because at the end you have to wait for things to happen, but you can now curl around the bench area. It's not closed off as at one time it was. This punched across now for Boyle, swung back up the wing, and it's Carcillo a shot that's directed wide.
By Letang.
I think the Rangers are doing better. They're getting through the middle of the ice a little bit more efficiently here in a second.
Here's Malkin with a shot that's blocked down. Malkin again, and that one was tipped high to the corner off of Boyle. Malkin sees it come right back to him again. Handed back on to Paul Martin. Flipped for Malkin. Went by Crosby to Carcillo. And he shoves one right into Kunitz. Kunitz trying to step by. Cannot. It's Stahl connecting on for Boyle to lob back off Letang's stick. Dominic Moore burrowed in and canceled there with Martin as it skied on up into the mesh and out of play with 6:20 to go here in the second of the game. Still tied.
I think what's happened, I mentioned the middle of the ice, and as the guys were saying back in the studio, Pierre showed the turnover package back in the first period. One thing that the Rangers have done, that they skated, they've taken the ice that has been given, they have moved the puck quickly, but they've had support. A much better part of their game through the middle of the ice, not giving any freebies to the Penguins coming back the other way.
Stopped on back now for the play to be made along by Scuderi, and then eventually reached. Adams played it up, and it's cleared back in by Gibbons. Around it comes for Lundqvist to fire on further. Touch back, but off of Stepan. Nice move here, and a 4-on-2. It's Stepan and offside on the play.
That's where you like to see Chris Kreider just use his speed straight ahead, push the defense back, and then make that play. You like the idea of trying to get the puck to the middle of the ice, but you got to make sure that that puck gets in over the line first. But again, another play for the Rangers coming through the middle of the ice. Not a lot of resistance there. Stepan made a real good play to get the puck through the middle of the ice.
This is the best he's skated in this series, 21 in blue.
Off a shoulder, jabbed on by Zuccarello. Pouliot to play it there. Pouliot again. And then Zuccarello, it's knifed away, but back to McDonough. Delays and shot one that's deflected wide. Zuccarello around behind. Zuccarello dropped a pass that was anticipated upon by Gibbons. Punched around into traffic. Pouliot kicked it along, but Niskanen there. And then along it comes for Adams. Directing traffic was Vitali, and Adams played it there. He's able to push it around behind. Rubbed out a bit by Girardi. And it's up the boards for Paul Martin yet again. Rattled around behind near Bennett. Cross-bodied and held there by McDonough. Punched around for Vitali. Angled on back for Martin. And Martin with a blast that's deflected into the mesh out of play. 5:10 to go. Second period of play. Tied at one. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico on NBCSN.
Well, we mentioned that we've not seen Brooks Orpik in the second period. This was his last shift back in the first period. The collision with Matt Zuccarello. An awkward finish there for Brooks Orpik.
And Bylsma looks on at an offensive zone faceoff for his team. 14:87-71 as usual after a TV timeout. Stepan sees this one by Crosby, marched on by Martin, back to Crosby and a shot, hit a skate. Drag back on and a two-on-one, it's Nash, save Fleury, the rebound bounced around behind Jack Free and then played by Martin up for Crosby.
I think if Kreider does not fall there, Doc, I think he's able to knock this puck out of midair in behind Marc-Andre Fleury. Because Fleury didn't know where that puck was after the shot from Nash. Again, another play through the middle of the ice for the Rangers.
Ifs and buts, and chock full of nuts. Martin with a pass on now to Kunitz and dropped right back in. Taken by Staal. Bumped off. Nothing much at stake here. 1-1, game four. Haglund stashed it behind. Mata chased off there.
Nice play by Mata there to win that battle over St. Louis and Richards.
Stempniak drifting. Through one that's gloved down by Girardi, played right back on the money for the carry back up now by San Luis. San Luis drifting, that pass went off Bennett, corralled by Mata, takes a look ahead and puts a pass ahead that can be dragged on by Bennett and thrown back in. Tries to get by San Luis and does. Knifed it around for the take by Stempniak. Stempniak canceled out by San Luis for the moment. Stashed behind again by Richards. And so starting back ahead with this and laying a pass on was McDonough, but it's down and icing is canceled. Brush back up the boards, can be played back on again by Sutter. Then along for the backhand in by Jokinen. Sutter moves in there. Nice control right back ahead by Strahlman. Got it on to Boyle, then right back to him once again. Here's Boyle trying to go to the net! And the puck tangled up behind. Boyle still working for it. Got it on to Dominic Moore. Moore got it to the back. Diaz a shot! And that one went wide. Stumbling down at the front was Boyle. Cut off now by Jokinen and given across to Letang. Moves back up with Sutter on his right. Neal on his left. It goes to Sutter and he can't settle it down. Rushed along Letang. A shot. Blocked off by Lundqvist. Carried back up again by Klein and shaken back ahead, but right into Scuderi. Poked it back, and it spun back in wide of the cage by Klein. Under 3 minutes to go, second period, and Kunitz steps ahead. Kunitz pivots and then dropped a pass along, hoping for Malkin. Jostled a bit there by Brassard. Malkin pushed it on through, and Brassard down to the ice he goes, and a penalty will be coming up.
Evgeny Malkin's going to go to the box. It's the stick around the skates of Derek Brassard. What a chance for Rick Nash and Chris Kreider. Crosby goes for the dive to keep the play alive. It doesn't happen. Watch the right part of your screen. The shot from Nash. The puck goes up. There's Chris Kreider. He's looking. Not able to find it as he falls on his wallet.
And for Sidney Crosby, Rick Nash and he get engaged right there at the boards. Crosby a little shaken up. Goes back to the bench. Little dinged. He'll be back.
That was one of those where he changed the level himself there once he moved that puck and just kind of looked like he lowered himself and Nash was coming to finish the hit.
Trouble shot is blocked down, corralled by Richards, given over to McDonough again, and then laid back deeper for a pass in front, carefully blocked by Skinnerian, popped out of play. What do we have? Nothing. So the power play continues, a 5-4.
Rangers are trying to make a lot of cross-ice passes there. The Penguins have done a great job. We here talked about Tony Granato in charge of the Penguin penalty kill. You're struggling power play. Anytime there's a lane there and there's somebody in front of the net, you got to fire that puck directly towards the net.
Trying to clear it was Martin. No luck. Persists and this time gets it back out and down.
He's just a tower of power for the Pittsburgh Penguins. He's gotten stronger. He's gotten fitter. He's been a huge force for the Pittsburgh Penguins, Paul Martin.
Tied for third in assists in the entire league in the playoffs behind Kopitar of Los Angeles and Parise of Minnesota. Bounces free for McDonough to fish along. Locked across now, and Gotch is able to play it right back down. No shots on this power play yet. Empty in 35 in a row are the Rangers. Carried back up by McDonough. Dropped back over for Nash. Dropped one through, and Letang chops it, and a chance now as Gibbons moves in all alone. Can't pull it off, and they score! The follow through came from Sutter. A short-handed goal, 2-1.
Well, this all starts in the middle of the ice. The Rangers are going to try to make a drop pass, but it's really the guys that are coming in this area here as far as the angle and the waves. It's Brian Gibbons with the stick right there that forces Rick Nash to his backhand, and then the hustle from Brandon Sutter to come in and pick up this rebound and goes top shelf with a sprawling Henrik Lundqvist.
Christopher Letang made an amazing play, Eddie and Doc. He bats the puck out of the air, and that creates that shorthanded situation for Gibbons. In alone, who scored earlier this playoff season, shorthanded against Columbus, and Brandon Sutter's there to pick up the rebound. A none too happy Henrik Lundqvist. But what a play by Letang in the neutral zone to bat that forward to Brian Gibbons.
Great angle there from Gibbons, forcing Rick Nash to his backhand and tried to make that play. And again, the angle through the middle of the ice. Very deliberate entry tried by the Rangers. The turnover and second chance opportunity.
That entry, by the way, that's a Detroit entry. Usually they leave that to Zetterberg or Datsyuk. Rangers have been trying anything to gain the zone.
Here's Kreider moving on this power play. Banked it around to Stepan. Stepan at the half boards, converged on by both Sutter and Mata. The battle must be taken to center ice by San Luis and through the legs of Adams. It is handed back across for Girardi and then San Luis and then off Girardi again. And fans are becoming restless. Kreider worked on effectively by Letang. It's punched on back for the glove play by Diaz. Handed over to Girardi and a wrister. It's Mike White and the rebound is punched along by San Luis before it can be stopped by Fleury. To the back it comes to Girardi. San Luis with it again. And an intercept there and a carry back up again by Sutter. Sutter delays, backhander save made by Lundqvist. A terrific play there by Sutter, answered by the goaltender for the Rangers. Vanessa on through now for the carry back now by Pouliot. Taken out of the play by Gibbons. And it is spiked back down. No icing here. 22 to go in the second period. St. Louis flipped one that's gloved down now by Kunitz and steered on back with Crosby and Malkin. It's on to Crosby. Delays, feeds on back to Scuderi. Rob Scuderi, wristed one, guided to the front of the net by Kunitz. Another shot would not go on the rebound by Malkin. Scuderi hands it on over. Kunitz with it there, 2 seconds to go. Flagged down and played off the glass by Diaz, and the horn sounds.
Well, after a giveaway by Marty St. Louis on a power play, here come the Penguins. Redirected. There's Malkin with the chance, and he tries to go back to the other side. And then Brandon Sutter takes the puck hard to the net. Good stop there from Henrik Lundqvist as Evgeny Malkin came out of the box. There you see that great play by Chris Letang to chip that puck up, as Pierre talked about, with Gibbons taking a puck to the net, and then Sutter puts it in top shelf.
Coming up on the Discover Card Intermission Report, Liam, Mike, and JR, Fleury's streak finally ends, Gabrick keys King's run. Sutter from Gibbons and Letang shorthanded at 18:27 gives the Penguins the margin of one. In the series, it is one as well. 2-1 Pittsburgh after two. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by the new Captain Morgan White Rum. White Rum has a new captain. By Honda, official vehicle of the National Hockey League. And by Verizon, the official wireless partner of the NHL. Well, the traffic on the GW is, at least in one direction, is going okay, isn't it? 2-1 in favor of Pittsburgh going into the third. Jetcopter traffic control, Pringles player profile of prolific players that are pipe polishers like this guy, Marc-Andre Fleury, 68 shots face and one goal allowed. You can earn a good living on that, eh? He's a thoroughbred.
Something
you
came,
like that?
Something came in my mind, Doc, when
with
I saw the traffic with the GW Bridge. Which way was it going? It looked a little bit more traffic-y going one way.
Yes, it did. And the Preakness is coming, speaking of thoroughbreds.
Yes.
Pierre mentioned earlier in the game. Anyway, it is a game of great gravity for the home team here.
Pretty aggressive pinch there from Dan Girardi.
Maybe that's the mantra for the third period here. That's what they've been told to do. Rattled on around now here for Kreider, but taken away by Malkin. Then Crosby, and played back over for Letang. Canceled out by McDonough. Kicked along, and Crosby got it to the back. Martin with it there. Malkin is shot, and it went wide. Could not be handled by Dominic Moore, or beg your pardon, by Kreider, but he's able to dive and poke that one on back for Paul Martin, and then Malkin can send it along for Niskanen. Niskanen's play is back in, out of the pie slice. It is Lundqvist able to force it away. Jokinen duels there. Five-man scrum. Neal couldn't dish it across. And so it is Zuccarello connecting ahead. Brassard with a shot that was wide. Niskanen along. Deflected back and flexed even further by Strawman. Mata goes to work. Strawman nicely able to keep that one. Then Brassard, and then Pouliot, and that one directed away by Jokinen. To me, the best offensive players per side have been 71 in white and 67 in blue, Malkin and Pouliot. I will take other votes if either of you have one.
No argument.
None from me.
We are unified. It's a great feeling, isn't it? Right back ahead with us now comes Hagelin, and Hagelin, the only goal scorer for the Rangers. Sent it across the net mouth, and Niskanen touched it on. Outletted by Stepniak and carried on by Gotch. Gotch nudged it back over, dipping the shoulder and pivoting with it now is Bennett, and dropping it on for Stepniak. Stepniak had it knifed off his stick by Diaz, played in the skates of San Luis, recovers, but it's right in the path of Bennett.
San Luis has really struggled. Had that giveaway on the power play, has no shots on goal in this game. Think about Richards, one shot, Stepan, one shot. Nash has got three, but some quality chances. Marty St. Louis really struggling here in game four.
This is Gibbons rushing back in, and his shot was blocked, and then Staal able to recover nicely and play it back on now for the carry back up by Dominic Moore. Rolled it through one, but plenty of Penguin reinforcements are back. And it is played out as far as center and back down where Strawman goes for it. Wedged off and up there by Gibbons that the reach-in comes from Adams back up near Vitali, but played by Niskanen, and right across it comes for Scuderi to lift it back in. Tipped off of Adams, played by Staal, kicked on back for Dominic Moore, shaken on back to Staal. 3 minutes played here in the third. Parcillo gave it on over to Dominic Moore, and then it carried right in off of a couple of Penguins on Fleury, and right back the other way comes Malkin. Shoves it on over to Kunitz. Kunitz tried to play it on through. It's blocked aside by McDonough, and the rebound came back out for the take back ahead and the throw back out by Carcillo that went away from Kreider and down, and they rule an icing, and there are those who disagree.
Oh, what a missed opportunity there for the fourth line of the Rangers. Dominic Moore, he had a chance to shoot this puck on his forehand, but watch, it looks like he's going to go to his backhand. Watch, he's got it on his forehand. And then I think what he was worried about was that Rob Scuderi was going to come over with the stick. But when it's on your forehand there, just get it to the net. Your team only has 11 shots on goal. Just fire it towards the front of the net. And I think at one point, at some point here, Elie Vigneault's got to look at changing up his lines. Move a guy in and out. You only got 11 shots on goal. You've only scored one goal in three games against the Pittsburgh Penguins.
And the Penguins are only playing with five defensemen since the first period with Orpik's injury, and a lot of different combinations. This is one that stayed the same, Letang and Martin on the ice right now.
Right now it's a little bit of a mixed bag for the Rangers because there's Carcillo getting knocked out of the faceoff to buy some time, and I hope the league looks at this moving forward here with this gamesmanship here to buy some time off the faceoff. Change that rule up a little bit on taking a false face out there, getting kicked out on purpose to buy some time on the icing call.
Not the normal guy that would come in on that. Kreider.
If you're a linesman there, you know what? Okay, just drop the puck and then that might stop happening.
Good point. Kreider on goal in the block by Fleury and the take by Letang. Away from Stepan, up the boards, it can be played by Jokinen, shoved on to Sutter, trying to get by McDonough, no luck.
Best hockey Brandon Sutter's played his entire NHL career in the last month in the first two rounds of the playoffs.
It is Nash roaring back in. Nash crosses, tries to get to the front, defended away by the Penguins. These are two strong defensive teams. The difficulty for the Rangers is scoring. Will that change here? It is punched away by Fleury after the drive in by Stepan. And it's forced back up the boards. They hope for Stempniak. And he's able to tip it away from Diaz to center.
No breakaway speed there for Derek Stepan. He had a chance, but give the Penguins credit for shutting him off. Again, a missed opportunity. Great chance there for Rick Nash. Great speed. Took it coast to coast. Tried to get the puck inside the dots. Nothing came of it.
Eddie, in game number three, Derek Stepan had a chance in the second period to go wide on Christopher Letang. Wasn't through the middle, but you could see he just didn't have that extra burst of speed that he usually has.
It is Bennett, hammered by Strahlman, played by Diaz, rattled on around and can be kept. But a mistake there from Mata, punched on back by Zuccarello, angled ahead, crushed by Stempniak and back in.
Mata's had a good bounce back game after struggling in game three.
Some bad turnovers in three, you're absolutely right.
Walked on by Brassard, finessed back in. Mata to get it there, got a skate on that one. Close quarters, Mata able to step out and brush it to Stempniak and then guide it on to Kunitz at center. This is Stahl, knifed away by Stempniak. Poked along by Pouliot, settles it down, then jostled off by Kunitz. Kunitz able to lob one back. It's taken by Malkin. Malkin puts on the brakes, fed it back over for Crosby, and he skates to his stick, and he swaggers a bit with it and throws one in front. That tricks behind. Can be played on by Kunitz. Letang a drive, and that one floated in front. On Crosby's backhander wouldn't go.
Strahlman in the backside after the stick malfunction there from Letang.
87 and 71 are buzzing. It is held by Lundqvist. Dunkin' Donuts takes you inside the glass with Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Doc. This is bad news for the rest of the Eastern Conference, potentially the rest of the league. When you look at Sidney Crosby, you talk about skill. Eddie knows what I'm talking about here. From your skate, to your stick, through your legs, you never lose your pace or your tempo, and then you set it up. Keep going, same sequence, hard on the puck, quick on the puck, Chris Kunitz, get it back to the point, shot on goal, watch 87, he wants the puck once, go get the puck again, he's gonna come over, force a turnover, just an amazing sequence for Sidney Crosby.
I see a future for you in play-by-play. Here's Hagelin on a cross in the turn and take by San Luis, and the follow-up comes from Richards. Here's Richards trying to center one. It went off of Letang and is turned back out. So Girardi and McDonough for the New York Rangers. 5:50 played here in the third period. They trail. Here's Gibbons, toe drag and a slide across. by Girardi. Checked off, though, by Gibbons. Moving in was Adams. Taken by Gibbons. Finessed on for Vitali. Kept by Niskanen. Back to the corner again. McDonough turns and met by Adams and then a little more aggressively by Vitali. And so it's Girardi connecting back over for Richards. Rips that one ahead. That's off the glove of San Luis. Retrieved by Neal and back to the defense. Nearly 6.5 played here in the third. On comes James Neal, moves in there with Diaz. Two aside, jab for it. Neal kicks it around behind and still playing right out in front. And Stepan was there. Now Kreider brings it ahead, throws it in and goes in after it with Niskanen. They shoulder. Niskanen played it up. Nash got it, threw one into the catching glove of Fleury. And play is stopped. 13-13 to go in the third. It is 2-1 Penguins.
Welcome back to Madison Square Garden. Here's Dan Girardi. He's going back for this puck. I mean, what are his options? His players are all back in this area here. There's really nowhere to pass the puck to. Nobody's getting available. And there's Brian Gibbons reading where Dan Girardi is the only outlet that he has to get the puck out of the zone. But not only got to work hard in the offensive zone, but you also have to work hard back through the middle of the ice to give the defenseman an option. Too much spacing there between the forwards and the D of the Rangers.
Stall shot canceled out by Neal. The two go back. Neal able to step free with it. Drops it back on for the take by Jokinen, and that one spiked wide by Zuccarello. Jokinen again. Spun one in front. He scores! Never a bad play to put the puck on net. It is 3-1 in favor of Pittsburgh.
Well, Jussi Jokinen took the initial shot as James Neal just wins a battle on Mark Stahl. Jokinen will take the shot. It's blocked by Zuccarello. And then watch him. Looks like he's going to go on his backhand, but he just fires it on his forehand. And off the right skate, I believe, of Mark Stahl.
Eddie, it all started, as you said, in that one-on-one battle between the 218s, Neal, and there's a puck off of Stahl's leg past Henrik Lundqvist. But it was the initial shot block by James Neal. And when he came to the bench, they were happy for Jussi Jokinen, but they were telling James Neal on the Pittsburgh bench, great shot block, Nealer.
This one is sent wide. The deficit is now 2. Girardi fired it around. Nash chipped it further, controlled by Mata, and slid over for Niskanen. Neal, the lone assist on Jokinen's goal. Jokinen's 6th of the playoffs. McDonough, but Niskanen, and that shot directed wide. We get a stoppage of play. It was from an offside.
And when you're not scoring, you got to do other things. And James Neal's not scoring, so what do? You get in the lane. Body on stick, not body on body. That means getting in the lane. Create a foot race situation after the block, and then the tenacious effort with the stick. Good, skillful play, and eventually Jussi Jokinen off Mark Stahl. Stahl started it, Jokinen finished it, but James Neal did a lot to help out.
That was great technique there by James Neal to attack the stick of Mark Stahl. And then you had the support of Jokinen.
Haglund trying to fight through Niskanen, coming across Kunitz, popped around for the take to the outside now by San Luis, gave it on back to Stahl. Stahl rifles one off the boards, off the back of the cage. Haglund tucked it in front, Malkin settled it down, and Crosby can advance for the Penguins. Crosby moves on with it now and fired one that's waffle-boarded away by Lundqvist. Tipped around behind for Malkin. He booted it on and is able to drag it further. Upended near the front of the net, Crosby. Meanwhile, it's played back on to Malkin. He's got Crosby. Crossover move, and it's stopped away in a neat play by Stahl, who is without a stick. Now it's Crosby leading it to the back. Letang with a shot. It's deflected to the high glass. Malkin dug it out there. Protected it with his body. Is coming along now as Letang. Letang flipped. Malkin took that stray stick there. Punched away, though, in a nice play back to the point, but then held by Martin over to Letang, and his shot was stifled there by Stahl. Cannot clear out. Played along by Vitali. Some tired guys back on defense for the Rangers as Dominic Moore gets to center and is walled there by Gibbons. Now it is Paul Martin. A little over 11 to go, third period. Brought back ahead by Adams. Rolled back in, and it can be played by Kevin Klein. Klein hoisted it around. Greened on to Carcillo, knifed away from him and settled down, but must be played by Diaz as the Penguins are changing. He's got some open ice.
Game rotation for Elaine Vigneault, not changing up the lines at all here.
Dominic Moore tried to center, no luck. Hits behind by Jokinen.
12 shots only now for the Rangers.
And sent through the net mouth wide. It was 15 for Pittsburgh last time, but they did get the win from it. Their lowest total of the playoff thus far. Forced along by Neal, kicked on back to Mata. Locked up there, trying to stagger free. And does so, but this one goes back down and will be an icing. The New York Rangers won their first championship in 1928. In the first round, it was two games, total goals. Both they and their opponent won a game, but they outscored that opponent 6-4. That opponent was named the Pittsburgh Pirates. It was before the day of Ralph Kiner, but they did have a team at that time, and that later moved on to Philadelphia to become the Quakers. But the Rangers' first championship was in the final at the expense of the Montreal Maroons, another team that is no longer around. Timeout presented by Gatorade. Fierce, more bold, intense flavor. The road ahead for the Rangers with 10:25 to go in the third.
Well, I think you still have to, first of all, you got to get the puck in the offensive zone. Less one-on-one, more odd man situations on the cycle, and get the puck first. And then any time the puck is shot around the board, you got to sustain some pressure. 12 shots is not going to cut it against a goaltender that's seen it real well in Marc-Andre Fleury. So expect defensemen. We saw it in the first shift of the third period, Doc. Dan Girardi jumping in, trying to keep the play alive. So expect Ranger defensemen to be pinching in every situation to try to keep the puck alive in the offensive zone. He might give up a 2-on-1 or 3-on-1, but you're in a situation now where you got to find a way to chip away.
Played off the boards and out. Neal tried to step ahead, could not. It's brought on by Sutter. Drifts to the outside, has Neal near the front. He glides behind and saw it taken away by Zuccarello. Zuccarello wristed one on a cross that is grabbed and played ahead by Pouliot. Pouliot trying to work through Canott. Zuccarello tried as well. Coming across was Bennett. Coming across was Stempniak. Well, that's just solid defensive play for the Penguins here. Omnipresent sticks, but now it's Zuccarello playing it around behind. Brushed off was Brassard, taken right away by Letang. Then up to Stempniak, tried to clear out, but Girardi pinned. Then Gotch run off by Pouliot. Gotch reached out and played it over to Letang, who hoists it all the way back into the Ranger end.
Nice soft play there from Letang. Didn't ice it, make sure he got it out of the zone.
Penguins in the midst of a change. Letang bunted that one right back in again, and he comes to the bench as well. And the clock now starting to become the enemy of the Rangers with 9:20 to go in the third. And a penalty will be coming up against the Rangers. Malkin, a shot is held by Lundqvist. And the power play is about to begin. Kreider to the box. Penguins to the power play, leading by two.
Sidney Crosby coming back on the back check. Gets good body position there, but then the follow through by Chris Kreider with the two hands right across the face of Crosby. As you mentioned, Doc, Rangers shorthanded.
0-for-2, the Penguins on the power play with no shots in either of those two. The usual gunners are out there, Niskanen and Martin. Sometimes it's been Letang. Carried back ahead now for Martin to twist on back to Malkin. Then Niskanen, a shot, it went wide, rebound off the boards, and trouble came from Kunitz. A good job done on him by Stahl. Fed on now to Malkin, deep slot, cruises with it, away from the reach of Haglund, got it on a cross for Crosby, but it was deflected out of play, no penalty, the good reach of Strahlman.
First, the mindset for the Rangers here is kill the penalty first, but if you get an opportunity, if your defenseman get a free opportunity, you know he's going to get the puck. You got St. Louis and Moore out on the ice. You start flying the zone. You're looking to take a chance. See if the Penguin defenseman hang around the blue line and try to keep it alive and look for a shorthanded chance.
Here's Malkin turning. Fed one out in front. Oh, and a great save made by Lundqvist on Kunitz. He is keeping them in here, or this would be all but over right now. And there's still time a-wasting on this power play. 1:15 to go, and 8.5 to go in the third. Touched over by Martin to Crosby. Sent on to the back now, Niskanen. Has to settle it down. Challenge came there from San Luis. Niskanen had a little trouble and had to peel out the center to eventually get control.
Good read there by San Luis, knowing Niskanen had a bouncing puck, and that's one of the pressure points you look for when you're shorthanded. and puck is around the boards or a player's fumbling it, going for it. That's when you got to pressure.
Rushing ahead is Neal. Neal, a shot blocked down by Lundqvist, picked up by Stepan and cleared. Lurie to handle, dishes it around behind. Letang to take over there. Has Jokinen making the sweep far side, near side sweep by Neal. Letang has options, carries to the red line, and is able to step in and put it right on goal. It's directed away by Lundqvist and blasted on out again. Bouncing puck settled down by Stepan, and Stepan, a shot that was deceptive, defended by Mata, and it skipped wide. They jostle free at center. 15 seconds left on the Rangers penalty kill. Neal settles it down. Carried on by Malkin. Steps by, drops on to Neal. His shot is high off Lundqvist, and another save. Boyle had it taken away by Malkin. Malkin trying to drift along with it. More time going off the clock. Penalty time is up. Out of the box, almost able to make a play was Kreider, and it's hoisted right back in again by Bennett. Four shots on goal for the Penguins that time after two prior shotless power plays. Zuccarello drifting with it now. Zuccarello for the backhand. Score!
Well, the best line for Alain Vigneault and the New York Rangers. Matt Zuccarello, Derek Brassard, and Benoit Pouliot. What a play here by Zuccarello. It'll get to the outside, hold on to the puck. Not a good goal given up there for Marc-Andre Fleury on the short side.
And if you're a Ranger now, every time you get the puck, you shoot it. Doesn't matter where you are. That is a bad goal to give up for Marc-Andre Fleury, and he knows it right away. Look at his reaction. So it's going to be white knuckle time right to the end here for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And let's remember some of the great saves Henrik Lundqvist has made to keep this a one-goal game.
Very good point. Zuccarello's third on only the second shot of the period for the Rangers. Strawman and Staal get the assists on the flashy Norwegian's goal. So now, Diaz, Pouliot, and his goal. Martin around. Vitaly further. Off Gibbons. Checked off by Klein. Stepping to it. Vitaly moving out with Adams, and he gave to him. And he flopped it off the boards back in. Chased down by Diaz. Shoved to the boards by Vitaly. Close quarters near Klein. Vitaly from his knees popped him high. Then Brassard. Cross-bodied by Adams. Brassard kicked it on. Came right back to him again. Bet out in front now for the settle down by Klein. Dished it back off the boards to center, and it's played back in by Zuccarello. Around it comes near Pouliot. Might as well double shift these guys. Not much to save them for. Carried ahead now by Paul Martin and walked on by Crosby. Filtered back in for Malkin. 6 minutes to go. Malkin breezing around behind. Touch one to Kurt. Kurt scores! From Malkin with 5:56 to go. The deficit again is two.
Well, what a heads-up play here by Sidney Crosby. He's just going to chip this puck in, allow Evgeny Malkin, again, playing the wing position, to get to this puck. Chris Kunitz gets in, finds a soft little spot. Marty St. Louis goes for a skate, and it's wide open for Kunitz.
Eddie, look at Ryan McDonough. No way, if he's healthy, is Evgeny Malkin able to create that kind of separation against McDonough. Not a chance. You're talking about a guy, people are going to try to shred him. There's no way McDonough doesn't close on him if he's healthy. Not a chance.
57 seconds apart. And so now it is a hole again for the Rangers of two goals. Stashed on by Strawman, played by Richards, jammed around, and Staal is there. Fired it behind for Richards, bounced off his stick and swatted it back. Staal will see it. Sent around behind again, and it ricocheted off of Richards, chopped on by Jokinen. Red there and nicely stepped ahead. Strawman tried to jam one in front, and it's picked up by Neal. Neal fed it on, Jokinen ahead. He's got Sutter up the wing, and it came to him. Sutter held, and then just tapped it around behind, and Neal comes by, bumped by Richards. 5:10 to go. So it is San Luis. Has to peel away now from the forecheck that came from Bennett. Some booing. We never really know who it's directed at sometimes, and I wasn't sure there, though it was coincidental with San Luis handling the puck. Meanwhile, Nash rocks into Martin. Back up the boards it comes again for the hold by Girardi. Nicely worked it along. Got it behind to Nash. The big man trying to step out. Run one in front. It came over to Kreider. Wide with the shot. And lobbed all the way back down in a race on. And Bennett's going to eliminate the icing so that Lundqvist has to come out to play. And it's skied on out to center. Club down there by Nash. Played back across to Kreider. Stoked on for Stepan, who wheels to the outside. And swung one in front. And it went off of Nash. Nash fired it around behind. And up the boards it comes near Klein. Klein touched it back. Stepan got it there and fired one that ricocheted wide. Diaz had it swatted away by Stempniak, but a good cover there by Nash. Rattle on around for the play of Brassard. Fed it on now for Pouliot above the club hand of Fleury off the glass. Bouncers touched on by Pouliot. Brassard tries to get there, has help from Zuccarello. Zuccarello led one back to Diaz, had to hurry and was canceled out pretty quickly. Aggressive work by Gibbons, but he bashed it back in and Fleury stopped with under 4 minutes to go here in the third. Laid off the boards, back out, away from Adams. Banged back off by Stahl. Second effort, he's able to do it there. And it's worked back up the wing, and here comes Pouliot with it. Pouliot button hook, falls, and a shot by Stahl was blocked. Carried back up by Adams again. Moves back up with Jokinen. Adams' shot is blocked down by Strawman and played by Stahl. Off of Dominic Moore's stick. Letang flies it right back in. 3:20 left. Strawman played it on. Carcillo led it across. Gets it back again from Dominic Moore. Carcillo able to shake by one. Jammed one to the front across the net, mouth wide. Boyle played it on to the back. McDonough couldn't stop. It's pushed on back as far as Girardi. Banged back off of Kunitz. Touched on by Crosby. Kunitz comes up with it there. Jammed one to the front that was read by McDonough. And he's able to curl right back up ice. Laid it on for the carry back up by Dominic Moore. Tries to get by Martin, no sale. Letang is there, and Boyle tries to outreach him. A log jam of two players aside, floated by Letang, ricocheted down off of McDonough, around behind to Boyle, through the legs pass, ricocheted back for Kunitz, who skyhooks it to center with 2:35 to go. More changes in lines. Girardi passes on. Hagelin with a step up the wing, shoots one, blocked off, and then covered a second time. And the whistle blown as it's held by Fleury. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico on NBCSN.
Going to go back to the goal by Chris Kunitz. Yes, Ryan McDonough gets beat by Evgeny Malkin, but I think anytime you have a defensive system is you have layers there, and Marty St. Louis goes for a skate, and look at the man standing right in behind him. It's Chris Kunitz. St. Louis sticks up in the air. Never puts it down. That allows the passing lane to get there. It's too late. So again, getting mesmerized by the puck. If Marty St. Louis just stays in the middle of the ice there with his stick down on the ice, that puck never gets to Chris Kunitz. So again, getting mesmerized by the puck. Yes, players are going to get beat, but that's why you have a defensive scheme to help out when players do get beat. And in that situation, two players got beat. The puck ends up in the back of the net.
Dan Bylsma created a monster. 87, 71, and 14. Crosby, Malkin, Kunitz. They're just starting to feel it right now.
Net empty. Glove down by McDonough. Played to the board. Pouliot able to get it around behind. Forced right back by Richards. Hustling is McDonough. And he got there and kept it in nicely. Bouncer, though, comes to Letang. Scooped it back on. With the net empty, they play it back in. And it's Girardi. Touch back on now for the play back across. It is Brassard turning with it. Brassard able to get as far as the checkered line, but then lost on the dump in to Paul Martin. Played on now by Sutter. Chipped across, and Letang carefully plays it back out of harm's way with 1:50 to go. McDonough got it across. Girardi's pass was tipped across to Zuccarello. The guys who have had the energy tonight for the Rangers are the ones that are out there for the finish. That makes a lot of sense. As back in it comes now for Letang. Wheeled it on around and it careened back. Nice keep by McDonough. Able to step away from one and hand it on back for a shot by Girardi. That's deflected up into the mesh out of play.
Shot blocked there from Chris Kunitz. After a terrific keeping, as you mentioned, Doc, by Ryan McDonough.
This Pittsburgh Penguin team has found their defensive conscience. Eddie, you talked about the shot blocked by Kunitz. It's James Neal with a shot block for a huge goal for the Penguins.
It's guys winning faceoffs and doing the little things right. It's not just the center. It's the wingers and defensemen helping one another out. And they've played most of this game with five defensemen, so a lot of different partnerships.
Niskanen plays it back off. Malkin could not get there. Tangles up with Diaz. Meanwhile, it's punched to the front. Nice reach by Mata. And then played off the front part of the cage and can be dealt along by Mata. And back down. Step on to get it. Rangers with 14 shots on goal. Evgeny Malkin has attempted 14 of his own. As this is laid back out to center and ladled back in by Kreider. Taken by Mata. Played on to Kunitz and Schenk back in again with 1 minute to go. Rangers have to get two. Take the chance with Russian roulette here. The net empty and a little pass ahead that's carried on now for St. Louis. And the shot is patted away by Fleury. Delled around close quarters and knifed away from Stepan. Niskanen ahead. And it's played back out again by Gibbons. Over to get it is McDonough. Gibbons harasses him. The pass ahead for Kreider. Tried to direct on and Sutter prevailed. Gets handed across to Adams. And then he's able to play it right in on goal. And it had to be stopped there as reaching with his stick was Girardi. 25 to go. Stepping along with it is Brassard. Rattled it right back in again and around the boards it comes to Martin. Drilled one along further that hopped off Girardi's stick. Tried to play it on. Punched by Martin. Gotten by Gibbons. Laid on out again and wanded on back in the final seven. And brushed along by Martin. It'll have to be fielded by Girardi. And the Penguins have won 3 in a row and 3 of 4 in the series. It was a strong night of goaltending for both guys. But this guy emerges victorious. Marc-Andre Fleury giving up 2 goals in the last 3 games and 5 overall in 4 games. The shots in the game, 27-15 in favor of the Penguins. And so it was 9-4 in the third period and 15 total for the Rangers. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico and NBCSN. Again, the final score 4-2 Pittsburgh. They lead the series 3-1. For Eddie Olczyk and Pierre Maguire, Doc Emrick wishing you a good night from New York. Now stay tuned for NHL Overtime presented by Bud Light right after these messages. 71,